Well, at this point in time, no prospective air carrier name is being made public, but we are told that the Pease Development Authority is in close talks with two air carriers who are looking at Pease. And just yesterday, the Pease Development Authority extended a deal with a consultant who's been working to attract airlines to come to Pease.
For a year and a half now, Pease has been working with an experienced airline industry consultant trying to attract new air passenger, cargo, and charter service to Pease.
The sooner the better, but there's no timeline. We want to make sure that whatever we get in here is going to be the right service for this airport, as well as, we want to be a good fit for that airline as well.
What Pease is selling includes this new 50,000 square foot air terminal facility, a giant 11,000 plus square foot runway which can accommodate any size aircraft, and a location 4 million potential customers can get to within an hour's drive.
The access to this airport is extremely easy. I don't think you're going to find another airport in the Northeast that has an off-ramp right off I-95.
And this is now the result.
There's a few airlines that we are talking with, and we have interest from airlines, we believe. And, time will tell. We shall see what happens.
Another selling point, Pease is able to offer airlines low fees and initial incentive packages that allow new airlines to come in and operate at no cost for 2 years. Meantime, local taxi drivers are thrilled hearing Pease is working to attract passenger air carriers.
It would certainly help business quite a bit.
A lot of people ask why this isn't an international airport or, a commuter airport.
Well, I really don't know what the market would be, but I know it would be definitely beneficial for the area as far as the economy goes, helping to boost up the businesses that are in the area.
And again, back live tonight, no official word on any timeline. And as far as how Pease is able to offer those deals to airlines, we're told that its airport costs are covered by Pease International Tradeport land lease revenue. So that's the answer to that. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Mike Garrity, WMUR News 9.